Hi there, welcome to my studio. Thank you for checking out this video. My name is Siobhan and this is Art Skills Online. If you're new to this channel, this is where I post videos about figure drawing and specifically about how you can develop your own dynamic and expressive style of drawing through drawing the figure. Each week I share tips and techniques about gesture and contour, and I also share my own drawings and my process as well. So if figure drawing is something that you're interested in, then definitely subscribe so that we can stay in touch. Today, I was working on a series of drawings with ink and charcoal, and I wanted to share this video with you and explain my approach to being selective when it comes to drawing the figure. When you're working on your figure drawing practice and you're working in your sketchbook drawing from photo reference, I think it's really important to remember that you don't have to draw the whole entire figure every time you sit down to draw. And I've mentioned this before in previous videos, but today I wanted to explain a couple of ways that you can approach drawing the figure where you don't have to draw absolutely everything. Personally, I find that being selective in your drawing is actually a really good way to develop your own expression. So here's a video. I'll explain a little bit more about this approach and then I'll check back in with you at the end. So just to explain a little bit of what I'm doing here in the beginning, I'm laying in an ink wash using a brush and some very light ink. So I'm just blocking out roughly the shape of the pose. Then I usually switch over to a pencil and work into the drawing with line. The ink wash like more or less corresponds to the shadows on the pose that I see, or the shadows on the model that I see, but they're not specific or precise shadow shapes, and really it's more a way for me to get some marks down on the page so that I'm not starting off with a completely blank piece of paper and, you know, drawing from scratch. So I like to have these marks as a starting point and then draw over them. I have posted a few videos using this technique, or this process I should say, so you can check out those if you want to see other examples. I really wouldn't go so far as to call this a technique as such. It's a way kind of to be intuitive and responsive at the outset. So today I worked on a few drawings. I'm sharing two of the drawing process in this video. In total, I think doing four of these drawings took me about 20 or 30 minutes. So the point I want to make is that if you sit down with your sketchbook for 20 or 30 minutes, you can get a lot done in that time. And the way that I make sure that I can move through a drawing session like that is if I don't put pressure on myself to draw the entire figure. So it comes down to being selective in your approach to drawing the figure and to focus on, you know, a certain area instead of drawing the whole thing. We often think that we have to get all and every part of the figure into our drawing, including fingers and toes and all of that, because that's what we see when we look at the model. We actually see everything, so we think that we have to try and draw everything. But there are a couple of things that you can do instead. One is that you could choose to draw a part of the figure as a study, like say the hands or the feet, or, you know, the shoulder girdle, the knee. That's a really great way to train yourself to learn and understand structure and anatomy. And that actually might be a bit more useful to you instead of trying to draw a really unsatisfactory drawing that kind of outlines everything on the model. The other approach, and this is what I do, is to focus on the gesture. And I've found that over the years, if you really know how to look for the gesture of the pose, that helps you a great deal to find or to see the most important aspect of the pose. And that's the part of the pose that really says the most. So that's what I tend to focus on. Finding that gesture in the pose is all about finding where the balance and rhythm, or sometimes it's called the energy, finding where that is, finding where that is originating and where it's moving to. Putting all of the rest of the details on top, you know, actually detracts from that gesture. So this might sound a bit abstract, and really finding the gesture is nearly always an intuitive response. It's kind of like that strong first impression that you got when you first looked at the pose and trying to draw that. And different people will see it differently. For me, nearly always, the gesture originates or has its dynamic quality in the torso. So that's what I tend to focus on, the tilt and the twist or the turn of the torso. And I think that if you can draw the torso of the human figure well, you nearly don't need to say much more about a dynamic pose. You know, maybe just indicate the direction of the arms or the legs. Really, that's all that's needed to express that gesture completely. So that's my advice for today. Look for that gesture. Don't worry about drawing the whole entire pose or the outline of the model. I'm not saying that this is the case for each and every drawing that you're going to do. I'm not talking about working on a fully rendered academic drawing, but certainly for gesture drawings, for working fast and effectively in your sketchbook, this is something I think you should consider. This way of working actually has two really excellent benefits beyond making a good drawing. One is that it'll help you to loosen up and therefore get really confident in your line work. And secondly, it will really help you to make your observation that much more laser focused and tuned into the pose. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got some useful information out of it, or at least some inspiration for your own drawing practice. Please let me know in the comments what you think. I'd love to hear your thoughts, or just say hi. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.